Welcome to Wellness on 27th. My name is Daniela, and today our guest is Lauren Castile.
Hi.
Hello. So, tell us a little bit about yourself. Why did you start practicing yoga?
Yeah, I'm Lauren Castile. I own Balance Yoga Bar, which is just right across the street on 29th and 7th. I went to school for music theater in Oklahoma City, and shortly after graduating, I actually had an eating disorder I was struggling with. And so after struggling with that for about 7 months or so, my best friend really wanted to help me. And so she did some research on things that would help people going through eating disorder recovery and found that yoga was really beneficial for people going through that. So she dragged me into my first yoga class. She made me go. And I ended up just like falling totally in love with it. I loved the instructors. I loved what it made my body feel like. I loved what it did for my mental health. And so I stuck with it.
That's a really good friend.
It's a good friend.
And
yeah,
congratulations
for you.
Getting over that.
Yeah, yeah.
That can get
you.
Really tough.
It's tough, yeah, but just like anything else, you can get past it.
Great. So what are your best tips for having a healthy mind and healthy body?
A healthy mind and a healthy body. Well, for a healthy mind, this is something that I've learned through yoga, is mindfulness. This is a practice of mindfulness. And what that means is to not let your emotions and your feelings have power over you, and instead to recognize those negative emotions as impermanent and just, you know, temporary, they're mm-hmm. going to pass. So, for example, instead of me, if I was like really nervous for this interview, instead of me saying, I am nervous, I could say, I am feeling nervous. And then that doesn't give power to that bad feeling, and it doesn't make me, I'm not defining myself with that emotion. Instead, I am just acknowledging that I feel it, and then it can pass.
That's really good.
Yeah, and then for a healthy body, I recommend really finding a fitness routine that works for you. So, you know, not necessarily what everyone else is doing. Find what works for you, because that's what you're really going to stick with. Mm-hmm. You have to find something that you enjoy doing. Otherwise, you're not going to want to do it.
Of course.
Yeah.
Like some people you'll see on the street just running 10 miles.
Yeah, that's not
like,
me. I'm not going to run. But yeah, like more
power
to
them. I'll run for the bus. I'm not going to run.
Right. More power to them for doing that and finding something that they'll stick with. But for me, that's always been yoga, bar, and Pilates.
So you said you owned a yoga bar. So what differentiates your yoga studio from other studios?
Yeah, so Balance Yoga Bar offers multiple types of classes, not mm-hmm. just yoga. We have bar, which is kind of similar to Pilates and ballet. We have yoga, it's hot yoga. We have hot Pilates. We have crazy core classes, which are just 30 minutes of core work. We have bar flow, which is a yoga bar fusion class. And we have a cardio bar class called bar frenzy. So we offer all these different styles of exercise, which is great because it gives you some difference in what you're doing every day. You know, it kind of breaks up your routine. And then also the thing that differentiates us from other studios in the city is that we are affordable. So that was our goal in opening mm-hmm. a studio here, was to bring something affordable to NYC so that these styles of fitness are available to more types of people.
That's affordable is
it makes
great.
A big difference.
It makes a really big difference,
yeah,
especially
yeah.
for college kids when we don't
right,
have.
Right, for college kids, for young professionals. I mean, I saw prices in the city when I moved here, and I was like, I can't afford those.
Yeah. This
so we made something that we could afford.
That's actually really good.
Yeah, thank you.
So, college.
Yeah.
We're stressed out.
Of course.
And it gets tough to set aside time to do something to, you know, work out 20, 30 minutes a day, maybe 3 or 4 days a week. What are some of the things you say that we can do, in your opinion, to be healthier or
right.
to do something that
right.
won't take too much time?
Well, if you can get into a class, I really recommend it. At Balance Yoga Bar, we give everyone their first class for free. We have these intro offers. You can do 2 months for $79. So if you can get into a class, get into one, because having the instructor there to really help you and guide you through your practice mm-hmm. makes a really big difference. But if not, if you don't have the time, I recommend a couple of things. I recommend finding just like even 30 seconds seconds or a minute a day where you can sit and close your eyes and just focus on your breath, just breathing in through the nose and out through the mouth. It's a calming breath, and so that's really going to be good for college students, just to give you that little tiny break, that little refresher during your day. And then for your body, I always recommend, my favorite exercise is a plank, and it targets kind of your full body. So, you know, it gets your shoulders, it gets your core strength, it gets your glutes. So just try to hold it for a minute a day. And if you can get to that minute a day and you do it for 30 days, you could lose an inch off of your waistline and just be feeling a whole lot stronger.
That's convenient.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's just like, you don't even have to work, you know, a plank a day for like a minute a day. You can do a plank a day for maybe 30 seconds,
yeah,
15
start,
seconds.
Yeah, start small and then build up.
So
just with everything else, yeah.
That's great advice. Thank you.
Thank you.
Social media. We're on social media all the time.
We are.
Every single day, almost every hour. And sometimes it'll help us feel bad about ourselves. Mm-hmm. It'll make us feel like we're not good enough.
Right.
So what are your tips or some advice that you can give us to use social media in a more positive light?
Right. Well, one thing is that your social media pages, your Instagram page, it's what you want it to be, right? And so you have the power to share your own content and to, you know, really focus on the message that you want to be giving to people and who you want to be. And so, you know, that's one thing that I recommend, is just focusing on what the messages are that you are putting out there in the world. But the other thing is that you can unfollow people who make you feel badly about yourself. You know, there's that old quote that comparison is the thief of joy. And I totally believe that. It's very true. And so if you find yourself, every time you are scrolling through Instagram, if you find yourself just feeling bad about yourself every time you see this one person's post, or if it makes you angry, or, you know, whatever that negative emotion is, then mm-hmm. just go on to their page and unfollow them. And then you don't have that daily reminder, you know, those posts that come in. You don't have that anymore. You don't have to see it.
And it's completely free to do.
Yeah, it's free. And free and effective.
And exactly. Thank you.
Of course.
For more information, go to balanceyogabar.com. Thank you for coming on.
Thank you for having me.
And thank you for watching. We'll see you guys next time. Yeah.